Hello YouTube, it's Norheron here. I've got something quite interesting to show you in this video. This is something I have tried to get several times in the past, but it is always out of stock every time I've tried to get it, but I got lucky and I was able to get it. It is Twinings number 22. Which is a black tea that is flavoured with toffee, golden syrup and caramel. Yeah, toffee, golden syrup and caramel, that's what it's flavoured with. Or as I say, flavourings, so that's a how they make those flavourings, I guess that's a trade secret. The recommended way you drink this is to brew it for 3 minutes, and it says milk is optional, you can drink it with or without milk. But people online say if you've never tried it before, it's best to try it without milk, because you can always add milk to it, but you can't take the milk out once it's in it. So it's best to try it without milk, and then add milk if you find you need it. So I've made it without milk. I don't usually drink black tea without milk, I normally have mine with milk. But people might recommend with this one you try it without first. So that's how I've made it. For those that like sugar in their tea, people say you don't need sugar with this because it's already sweet, because it is a sweet tea, it's flavoured with toffee, golden syrup and caramel. It's actually called number 22 dark caramel, that's its full name. So it is a sweet tea. Yeah, they don't say what they make the flavourings out of, they just say flavourings, they don't say what, how they make those flavourings, so I guess that's a trade secret. It says it's got tea, obviously, black tea, and then it says caramel, golden syrup and toffee flavourings, but it doesn't say how they make those flavourings. I think it's time to try the tea and give it a rating, and if I find that I need milk with it, I will have to go away in the middle of the video and add milk. Because I usually drink black tea with milk. I don't normally drink it without. I drink my coffee without milk and without coffee mate, but with tea I normally have a very small amount of milk in it. So this is going to be a new experience for me. I've not tried this tea before, so this is my first time trying this number 22 dark caramel, because every time I've tried to buy it, it's been out of stock, but this time I was able to get some. Yeah, it's definitely sweet. It's definitely a sweet tasting tea. I really don't think you would need sugar in this. I think people online are correct when they say you don't need sugar. Although I don't have sugar in my tea anyway, but if I was someone who did, I wouldn't need sugar in this. And I like it how it is, so I don't think I'm going to need to go away and add milk. I'm glad I tried it the way people recommend first, which is to try it black without adding any milk. I'm glad I did that because I can taste the flavours better, which is why people recommend drinking it black, so you can taste the full flavours better. And that's the reason I recommend trying it black first. I'm glad I did because I don't think this needs milk. It does have caffeine in it, so you shouldn't have it too close to when you're going to bed. It has less caffeine than coffee because it's tea. Tea generally doesn't have as much caffeine as coffee by a cup, which is why I'm drinking it at this kind of time, because it's early enough that I can drink tea and still be able to sleep, but if I was to drink coffee at this kind of time I might have problems sleeping. But because it's tea, I shouldn't have any problems with sleeping. But if it was later than this, then I would have to wait till tomorrow before trying this tea. I would have tried it earlier in the day, but my delivery only came very recently. They gave me quite a late delivery. I can't do anything about that, that's just when it arrived. But I do really like the tea. I highly recommend it to people who like sugar in their tea, because this is like a tea that is sweet, so you don't need sugar. Online it says it's only 4 calories a cup, so if you are on a diet and you want to still have sugary tea, you still want a sweet tea but you're on a diet, this would be a good option for you, because online it says it's only 4 calories per cup. On the box they don't say what the nutritional information is, but online it says 4 calories per cup. Which really isn't much at all. A tea made with 1 teaspoon of sugar, even just 1 teaspoon, is going to have a lot more than 4 calories. So if you are counting calories but you want a sweet tea, then I would recommend this. Twinings number 22. Dark caramel. It is sweet. It's not overly sweet. It's perfect for my tastes, because it's sweet enough to still be nice for someone who doesn't only have sugar in their hot drinks. So if you do want something sweet but you are counting calories, this could be a good option for you. Or if you just want to try something different, if you're just like me and wanted to try something different out of curiosity, this could also be a good option for you if you can guess it. They do sell that in shops as well, but unfortunately where I live, they only sell standard tea, standard coffee and standard hot chocolate. That Twinings number 22 is a specialty tea, so it's not sold locally where I live. I have to get it online and it's normally out of stock. I would happily drink this every day if I could get it reliably, but it's normally out of stock, so it's not going to be something I can have every day. But if I could buy this easily, I would. I would have this as an everyday drink. It is a really nice tea, and I think I need to give it a rating. And the rating this gets for me has to be a 10 out of 10, with 10 being the best, 0 being the worst. That's how my rating system works. I'm giving it a 10 out of 10 because I really like it. I wasn't sure what I was going to think of a sweetened tea because I don't normally like sugar and stuff in tea and coffee. I don't normally like that at all. But this is nice, I really like it. If I knew what they used to make it taste like that, I would make my own. But I guess they're going to keep that a trade secret. I really like it, so I'm giving it a 10 out of 10. The tea bags are designed for standard teacup size, not mugs like this. I compensated for that by only filling the mug halfway, which is about as much as a standard teacup. Because we don't have any actual normal standard teacups, we've only got mugs in this house, so I just filled this mug halfway, which is the equivalent of a standard normal teacup. That is how you can get around it if you are in a if you're in the same situation, you've only got mugs, just fill the mug halfway. Yeah, I really, really like this tea, and I'm glad I was able to finally get some. I've been trying to get this for ages, but every time it's out of stock. So it must be very popular because it's always out of stock. And I can see why it's popular, because it's very nice. It's more expensive than standard tea, because it is a speciality tea. But in my opinion, the extra money is worth it. I think the price is worth it for the quality of the tea. It is a very nice tea. It is worth the money. I'm glad I bought it, and I will definitely buy this again if it is in stock. It is something I'm going to continue to get because I really like it. I wasn't sure what I was going to think because I'm not only a fan of sweetened teas. I normally really do not like sugar in tea or anything like that at all. But I really like this. So I'm happy with the 10 out of 10 rating I've given it. I'm very happy with the tea. I really like it. If you like sugar in your tea, you'll most definitely like this, because if I like it and I don't normally like sugar in tea, anyone who likes sugar in their tea is probably definitely going to like this. I can't say what other people in this house think, because I'm the only tea drinker in this house. No one else in this house drinks tea, apart from me. Everyone else only drinks coffee, and that's it. So I can't ask what other people in this house think of the tea, because they probably wouldn't want to drink it, because they don't drink tea. But I do drink tea quite a lot. I'm a quite big tea drinker. I really like this tea. I'm happy with the 10 out of 10 rating I've given it. And if you are someone who does like sugar in their tea, or you just want something different, I highly recommend the Twinings number 22 dark caramel tea. I highly recommend that tea. It is a very, very nice tea. That is the tea finished. I'm very glad I bought it because I really, really, really like it a lot. I think it deserves the highest rating I can give it, which is 10 out of 10. As I've said several times now, because I really like the tea, and I do highly recommend it to anyone who likes their tea to be sweet, or anyone who just wants to try something a bit different. I don't think you need milk in that tea, in my opinion, but everyone is different. If you're going to try the tea and you've never tried it before, I would recommend what people online say, which is to try it without milk first. And if you feel that you need milk, then add milk after you know what it's like. Because you can always add milk, but you can't take it out once it's in. So I would recommend brewing it black, trying a few sips, and then if you really don't like it without milk, just add some milk. They do recommend a different type of milk than usual. They say you can use normal milk, but they say it works even better if you use hazelnut milk. I've never tried hazelnut milk, so I can't comment on that. That is just what the box recommends. We only have normal milk, but if you happen to have hazelnut milk, maybe give that a try. If you do try it with hazelnut milk, maybe let me know in the comments how it was. I'll be very interested to know, because we don't have hazelnut milk in the house, so I can't try it that way myself, because we normally only buy regular cow's milk. That is normally what we get. We don't normally get other milks. We did have almond milk once, but that was before lockdown, and that was something I bought myself, and I drank it just as milk. I didn't put it in any drinks, I just drank it as a cold drink. But that's the only plant milk I've tried. That is what I think of the tea. 10 out of 10. Maybe if you tried it, let me know what you think in the comments, or if you're going to try it, maybe let me know. I'd be interested. That is what I think of the tea. If you like this video, maybe give it a like. If you really liked it, maybe subscribe and ring the notification bell for more content. I've been Norheron, and I'll see you again next time. Have a good one.